Hi and welcome back to the MIGRO YouTube channel. My name is Shane and I'm the founder of MIGRO. In this video, we're going to look at the effects of different full spectrum grow lights on plant growth and yield. We've set up an experiment and we are going to show you a time lapse grow over the last 6 weeks of a selection of bedding plants and lettuce, which we put in each of the bays here. We've got three different types of full spectrum grow light. We start off with the MIGRO 100, which is drawing 106 watts. It's a full spectrum LED COB. That's been raised quite high because of we're keeping the intensity of the light the same in each of the bays. In the next bay, we have a blue-red LED, panel type LED. In this case, it's a UFO. And it's drawing about 165 watts. And in the last bay then, we have a dual spectrum CFL, which is a 250 watt Electrox model with reflector, which is drawing 200 watts. So we've set up each of the bays with the same plants underneath, the same PPFD or power level across the top of the canopy in each of the bays. And we've run the experiment for 6 weeks. We're going to look now to see what the health of the growth is like, what characteristics the growth has, and what the yield is in the end. So all of the lights have been set up to give the same power level across the same collection of plants under the same conditions. The difference in terms of the results from the growth is going to be determined then by the grow light spectrum. We have tested each of the grow light spectrum using our Asensetek passport. It's a spectroradiometer. And from these readings, we're able to show you the proportion of the different spectrum of light in each of the grow lights. We can show you here the table using the sun as a reference. These grow lights are sold as full spectrum lights, which means they should be replicating the light of the sun as close as possible. The infrared is effectively heat and doesn't contribute to light growth, to plant growth, and neither does UV, so we can not look at those for the moment. We're just looking at the proportions of blue, green, and red. Blue is known to control plant growth, specifically the lengths of stems, and therefore affects how stretched or how dense the plants are under the grow light spectrum. We have shown previously, and it's scientifically proven, that blue light between about 15 and 20% is optimum. Between 15 and 20%, you get short, dense growth. So there's enough blue there to control and keep the plant growth dense, but not too much, because more than say 20% of blue light is going to reduce the productivity. Next we have green. Green is proven to be almost as efficient as red in terms of photosynthesis, about 95% as efficient. And the big benefit is that it bounces down through the plant canopy and gives you really good penetration down into your grow, getting lots of flower and bud development down into the plant. Next is the red, the most highly efficient photosynthetically. And so we're going to see for these mixes which performs the best in our grow test here. So let's look at the results. We've taken the plants now out of the growth chambers to have a look to see how they did over the 6 week test. Starting on the MIGRO side, just looking at the bedding flowers. Good healthy growth, lots of nice sized flowers right across the violas and the pansies. Looking at the lettuce then, you see the growth's nice and dense. The main head here is good and thick. with very dense gather growth there in the center, and the smaller heads are nice and dense too. Looking down underneath the UFO, very good flower development on both the violas and the pansies. The growth on the lettuce is a little bit more stretched, with very good weight and density on the main head, and a little lighter and fluffier on the younger heads. Then under the dual spectrum CFL, we've got pretty good flower development, very good flower development actually on the viola. But here on the pansies, unfortunately, got a bit of disease and infestation just the last few days. But they were looking nice and healthy up to that point, so no concerns there. Looking at the lettuce, you can see it's a much higher growth, more stretching, much less dense, a lot lighter on the main head, quite scraggly and light, and on the smaller heads as well. So overall, good development on all the plants. The UFO's probably got the best in the flowering response, with MIGRO second and the CFL third. On the lettuce, I'm looking at the health of the growth. MIGRO has the shortest, densest growth with the what looks like the biggest mass, with the UFO second and the CFL third. Let's get let's harvest the lettuce and see what weights we get. We can see all the results now for the grow test. On the left hand side, we've got the MIGRO at 106 watts with good flowering, dense growth, and the highest yield at 318 grams. The UFO draws 165 watts, good flowering, dense growth, and the second best yield at 272 grams. The Electrox Dual Spectrum CFL, badged as 250 watt. But draws 200 watts. Had good flowering, but unfortunately the growth was light and stretched, and it developed a low yield of only 130 grams. So seeing all the results from the comparison grow, you can see that the red-blue LED from UFO along with the COB spectrum from MIGRO both deliver strong, healthy growth. It's often said that the green portion of grow light spectrum is not productive and doesn't photosynthesize and deliver yield. You can see from the test that the green portion or the mixture of green into the spectrum in the COB LEDs actually delivers a slightly higher yield for the same power levels across the grow area. However, the blue and red LED, the UFO, did deliver slightly better flowering, so there was slightly more petals and slightly larger size. The CFL grow was very disappointing. The Electrox Dual Spectrum CFL was badged as 250 watt, but only drew 200 watts, and then delivered a stretched and low yield. It's likely that even though the power levels measured across the grow were the same and the light was hung as low as possible to the plants, that it was spreading the light a bit around the plants and not getting directly onto the grow, so it probably suffered a little bit that way. But as I've seen in other grow tests, the relative yield from a CFL is much lower than from LED. So I hope you've enjoyed. If you have, please subscribe and take care.